you videoing this? Yeah. Oh, you did give us a thumbs up. I thought it was weird.
Hi, I'm here with my mate Ben Stokes to review the first test. So Stokesy, what do you reckon? Cookie, you think you did all right?
I did all right, didn't he, the bunny lad? Stuck him well for the lads. You know, he basically was out in the field for 4 days. Amazing effort, really, wasn't it?
Pure concentration, I think, Ben. Pure concentration, like a Jedi warrior. I'm sure, like, at one point he was actually using the force because they just weren't going to get him out, were they?
The word, we definitely wasn't using the force to hit the boundaries because, I mean, I think he only hit about 15.
15 boundaries, is that all it was?
I think so.
I tell you what, that man can bat. Ben, what about our debutant, Adil Rashid? What do you reckon? You think he died?
Well, I tell you what, he spun the ball a long, long way.
Long way?
Long way.
Left or right?
Gone Jamaican, but...
It was hard, graph, like one of 4 days in that heat. Whoa, I've never felt it so hard. Bit different from Asherton in the northeast in general. What do you reckon, Ben?
I'm ginger and all. Not just about being from the northeast.
You lay the cream on?
I was melting.
You lay the cream on, though?
Yeah. Tan.
You've got to have a tan in the
you
northeast.
You do. Aye. Well, red eye. Aye.
Red eye.
White t-shirts and that night would eye.
Right, so Ben, you're a canny fast bowler. You know, you've got a bit of boot here, scare people, bowl canny fast. But you also did bowl off spin. Want to tell us about that?
Well, I mean, Cookie just comes up to us and goes, do you fancy hoy and doing some spinsies? And I was like, well, I gone then. I mean, I bowled him the nets in there, so I was like, might as well give it a shot in the test match.
Went all right, didn't it?
No.
Nah.
Bowled 2 full tosses.
Oh, no. Worst kind.
I don't think I'll have another go, like.
And the most magical part of the day, Ben, one-hand pick-up and throw. That was absolutely mint, that. What are you writing?
Well, I just summed it up. Picked it up one hand and threw.
Threw the stumps down, didn't you?
I did, aye.
He was miles out.
Aye, hoyed it.
Aye. Like, hard as you could, like.
Aye, get hard as I could. That's about it.
Some fielder.
Aye. I mean, Trevor always guns about hit the tape on the bottom of the stump, so pick the ball up and that's all I was wondering about.
Great stuff.
Just like to thank Ben for his interview and we'll probably review the second test as well, but for now, thank you. Hello, welcome to Dubai International Cricket Stadium. The lads are just finishing up behind me here. We've just had a good group chat before the day. Just outlining, obviously, the last game and what we're going to do this game. Last game, we've talked about what we did well and where we can improve. For myself personally, I've had a bat, sort of getting used to conditions here, and had a little bit of a bowl through. That's just to get a feel of the stadium, the pitch that we train on is often similar to the one that you play on, especially day one. The pitch here training was a little bit skinny. I guess suits my bowling a little bit because you can afford to bowl just a slightly bit shorter and it'll just skid on and still hit the stumps. I didn't feel like there was much spin when I batted against it. I mean, maybe the spinners can let you know, but hopefully days 4 and 5 that it'll turn like it did in Abu Dhabi and we can pick up wickets there. The sessions before games often probably last a couple of hours max, but that's not everyone does 2 hours. It's sort of half an hour to an hour each individual stuff. I reckon I've bowled for probably 10 minutes, that's all, and it wasn't high intensity. I probably bowled off my full run for probably 12 balls, that's all, because you want to go into the game relatively fresh. You probably bowl for 40 minutes on a proper training day. The coaches don't really give you an indication of how much you've got to do. It's very much player-led and up to you about what you want to do. Towards the end of the session, I did some running techniques just to help you be a little bit more efficient, I guess, and conserve a little bit of energy. And for me, it certainly helps with my run-up when I bowl. And I think the little 1%ers that would do certainly help with your overall performance, I guess. And I did a little bit of a core exercise as well, just to make sure that I'm feeling strong and ready for the game. The strength and condition coach is Phil Scott. He's a pretty good guy. Spitting double of Lord Farquhar, so he'll be pleased that I've said that. Look, he's a top bloke who helps the lads out at any time he can. He's always in the gym with the lads. I'm sure he's just as tight as everyone else because he does about 4 sessions a day with every one of the lads. So he's another one, hopefully, later on the blog, you'll get to know. As many of you know, Mahela has been with her for a little period of time as a consultant, someone who's a bit of a specialist in these conditions and someone who all the lads had immense respect for. He was good in the change room. He took to the fact that I put plates in his bag pretty early as a joke. He seemed to take that on board.
His bag weighed about 3 ton, but he saw the funny side of it. So he's been involved in the crack straight away. He's given little tips. For example, personally, he said to me about my bowling in these conditions. So he talked about the Pakistanis playing the hook shot from wide, and that I would have to bowl it maybe slightly straighter. And then he just said about mixing my angles and particularly about reverse swing. Noticeable thing, I think a few of the lads I took on board was at breakfast. He used to be a serial cramper, apparently. I'm not a big one that cramps. Well, I say that now and probably will turn up the game and I'll be on all fours. But anyway, he just mentioned that he didn't used to eat breakfast. He used to be quite lazy coming down the team bus and getting ready to go. And he used to find that the lack of sort of carbohydrates and I don't know, the dietary stuff that you're meant to eat. He didn't have enough of it, and then by the end of the day he was worn out and cramping up. So the next day I think Rudy and everyone were down at breakfast, whether they were having watermelon or 2 Weetabix or 4 Weetabix. That was everyone was down breakfast the next day, taking them little tips on board, because he certainly knows how to play in these conditions.